Jesus said, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled." My friends, this is the joyful feast of the people of God. This table is for all of us who come from near and far, from high and low, from north and south, and from east and west. And according to the Gospel of Luke, when our risen Lord was at table with his disciples, he took bread and blessed and broke it, and he gave it to them, and then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him. So my friends, this is the Lord's table. You are all welcome. You're all invited. You're all called to share the feast which our Lord has prepared. Let us pray. God of our salvation, we do not deserve your love, and yet you lavish it upon us. Having a desire to not be apart from us, you sent your Son to us, coming in the flesh and becoming one of us. You're not a God that is removed from our reality, but is intimately there and present in our lives and our struggles. We lift up to you our thanks for your presence among us. We give thanks for your Son, Jesus Christ, the very incarnation of your being on this earth. We remember how you called your servant Mary to bear your Son, how you called your servant Joseph to accompany her, and how you called the wise men to search and the shepherds to ponder, how you called John to proclaim and Jesus to be baptized, and how you called Peter, Paul, and the disciples to follow. We recognize that in Christ's death and rising again, you set before us the sure promise of new life, the certain hope of a heavenly home where we will sit at the table with Christ our host. Lord God, by what we do here in remembrance of Christ, we celebrate his perfect sacrifice on the cross and his glorious resurrection and ascension. We declare that he is Lord of all, for his coming in his kingdom. We give thanks for your gifts of grace and ask that your Holy Spirit will come to bless this sacrament that we might preside with you and you in us. May we be one with all who share this feast, with all your children at every corner of your table. May we be united in hope, united in vision, in purpose, in ministry, in every place. As this bread is Christ's body for us, send us from this table to be the body of Christ in all the world. Keep us faithful and fruitful and hopeful until we come at last to the one table of your kingdom to feast with all your saints, with you and with your word, through Christ and in Christ. And to you, one holy and eternal God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we give praise and glory, now and forever. So, with thanksgiving, we remember how Jesus took the bread, and when he had blessed it, he broke it, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Ministering to you in his name, we now give you this bread. This is the body of Christ broken for you. Do this in remembrance of him. With thanksgiving, we also remember how Jesus took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant sealed in my blood, which was shed for many for the forgiveness of sins. Drink of it, all of you. Do this in remembrance of me." Now, ministering to you in his name, we now give you this cup. This cup is in the covenant in the blood of Christ, which was shed for many for the forgiveness of sins. Drink of it, all of you. Do this in remembrance of me. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, you are truly Emmanuel, God with us. In this season of hope, may the meal we've shared together nourish us to be your body in the world. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. With the angels in heaven, we join in singing your praises. Glory to God in the highest, Hallelujah.